What's up guys, I'm De'Aaron Fox and I'm here with my boy Khoi from HyperX and he's here to set up my OBS so I can stream on Twitch. Come check it out.
All right, to get you started streaming, we're gonna download OBS Studios. Just go down here, click Windows 7, unless you have a Mac, download a Mac. While it downloads, we're gonna do your speed test, see how fast your internet is. This will help us measure how much bitrate we can use for your stream to show the quality. Jesus.
I'm looking at it like, dang.
The most important thing for streaming is your upload speed. So yours at 11, which is really good. It's almost at 12. For most people, we say use a third of your upload speed. For you, we're gonna max out at 6,500 for partnered streamers, which is really good.
So what's the download speed for?
We don't need that for streaming specifically, just mainly for when you watch Netflix. That's what you use. You use download speed or YouTube.
Okay.
So you can set up your settings for OBS just by clicking the settings tab right here. Most of the default stuff for the general is perfect. For streaming, you're gonna go streaming services, make sure you choose Twitch unless you wanna go somewhere else. But for us, we're gonna do Twitch today. Yeah. Server, just auto recommend it'll choose the fastest thing. Now we gotta get the stream key. So for that, we gotta go back to your Twitch page, which is over here. You're gonna go to settings. Yeah, right into settings, you can hit stream key. Show key. Make sure you don't show anybody on your stream this ever, because then they can get onto your stream with just this code.
Okay. You just kind of just copy it.
Yeah, you're gonna copy it. Okay. There we go. So for this stream, we're gonna show you using this key. We're gonna reset it afterwards, just to be safe. Hit apply. We're gonna go to output. So your upload was 12 megabits. So we're gonna go with 6,500. That'll be more than enough to go. We're gonna go with hardware because you have a really powerful video card. Software is using your CPU.
Okay.
We're gonna leave that at default. We're gonna go straight to audio. This is perfect the way it is.
I'll definitely be asking questions about this later.
Anytime. For your base canvas, that's your resolution that you see, not your stream, but you see. The output is what your stream sees. We're gonna leave it both at 1080. A lot of people do a downscale to 720 because it's easier for your viewers to see higher, like lower quality in case the internet isn't as great. Mm-hmm. We're gonna go to 60 FPS just cause your computer is a monster. And you can easily run any stream at 60 FPS.
Said it's a monster.
It's a monster. So right now we don't need scene keys cause we're only gonna make one scene for you. But later on you can add multiple scene keys just by F1, F2, it'll like switch between different games.
Okay.
But for now we're gonna focus on one. So with that, we're done with settings. Next we're gonna go into scenes and sources. All right, so here we're gonna start with adding your game, which is for you, it's gonna be on a PS4 Elgato on our left. So we're gonna do that by adding video capture device right here. We have it all plugged in because we're awesome. Oh, that's webcam. Let's switch it to Elgato.
Elgato.
Boom, so NBA 2K is showing. All the settings are perfect, just leave it how it is. Now we're gonna add the webcam. We're gonna add your webcam just by doing the exact same thing, video capture device. Choose which webcam, which for us would be this one. So whatever is on top down here in the sources is what shows on top. So if you put this under the Elgato, it'll be hidden. Just like paper, whichever paper sheet's on top.
Okay.
If you wanna hide the webcam, just click the eye icon, it disappears. Change the size, just click it, drag the arrows, move this to the bottom left for now. Then we're gonna add an overlay. So for us, will be image overlay. Let's create the image. We're gonna go find the file, DF overlay. Boom, right there. Put this under the webcam.
Is this what we're trying to fit it in?
Yeah, we're trying to fit it there. So that's pretty much it. Now your PS4 is set up to stream. If you wanna do, let's say you wanna play PUBG. We're gonna load up PUBG through Steam, hit play. Once it loads, just press Alt-Tab, which will bring you back to the OBS.
Alt-Tab?
Yeah. And then you hit Game Capture. You're gonna name it PUBG. You're gonna click Specific Window. Then choose the window, which would be Player Unknown Battleground. Hit OK. And then just make sure it's under your overlay. So bring it down to the bottom.
And what'd you hit with that?
That'll just control up and down arrow key, or you can choose the arrow keys down here as well.
Oh, okay. So instead of using-
Yeah, just like hotkey.
Now it's on. Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So that's how you set up either a PC game through Steam or using your Elgato, just video capture device or game capture for on your PC.
Okay.
The point of game capture is to save your FPS. So it'll put less strain on your PC, which means you have more performance. All right, so for the next one, we're gonna use your webcam, we're gonna use our green screen, and we're gonna chroma key it.
So what's a chroma key?
Chroma key is choosing one singular color to illuminate and make your background transparent. So for us, we're gonna use-
So will my chair pop up?
No, it won't pop up, it'll be invis.
So wait, would the fox pop up though?
Yes, it will.
Hey, floating fox, I'm gonna put like this.
All right, so for that, we're gonna go onto it. We're gonna go to filters. We're gonna, on the bottom where it says effect filters, we're gonna hit a plus, hit chroma key. You can name it whatever you want. For us, it's just gonna be that.
Hey!
There you go, fox pops up. Because of our lighting, we're gonna change the settings a little bit. Just kind of mess around with it till it blends in more. Like this blends in perfectly, you stand out. That's what we need. So we're gonna hit close. Make sure you never wear green shirts, green pants, so you just have a floating head. Unless that's what you want.
That don't sound too bad.
Just don't wear a green beanie. This will look really weird.
I can't even put it on my head.
All right, so we're gonna show you just you. Ready? That's you. You see your fox behind you? So it stands out perfectly. You just gotta mess around with the settings a little bit, tune it back left and right to see where everything blends in properly. And then before we end the video, I'm gonna give you three tips on how to grow your stream, your community, for your viewership and everything. Number one is consistency, which you might have a hard time with because you're so busy.
Yeah, definitely.
But for other streamers out there, just stream every day, create a schedule, just keep doing it. It's a grind. Always engage your viewers. So as you're playing, check your chat, read your chat, just talk with them. That's why they're there. And number three is find the reason why people would want to watch you. If you don't find yourself entertaining, nobody else is going to find yourself entertaining.
Okay.
So make sure you can just be whatever streamer you want to be or whatever entertainer you want to be. And those are the big three keys.
Two out of three ain't bad.
That's pretty good.
It's failing great in school though.
Well, thank God it's not school.
All right, guys, thank you for watching this video. I also want to say thank you to HyperX for helping me set up my streaming channel. It'll be Swipe of the Fox, SWIPATHEFOX. All of my social medias will match.